What's up, Bose? We're starting our Monday out here at the Les.
We got a lot to unfold, so without further ado, I'm Ashanti. We got JT behind the camera.
And I'm Jason.
And this is your Rainbow Roundup.
Rainbow Warrior Volleyball continued to dominate as they won the Outrigger Volleyball Invitational. UH continued to sweep the competition like the court was dirty, picking up wins against Lewis and number one ranked Grand Canyon. Alakai Todd played a huge part, taking down the number one ranked team, racking up 11 kills and 3 blocks. The final match of the week against UC Irvine kept fans on the edge of their seats. The match went the distance as UH was able to pick up the win in the fifth set, 15-13, making them tournament champs, as 3 Rainbow Warriors were named to the all-tournament team. The Bows will look to continue their 16-game winning streak in California against Long Beach State on Friday and Saturday.
Rainbow Wahine Basketball is officially the Big West regular season champs and clinched the top seed in the Big West Championship starting this week. The regular season title is the second in 3 years for the program and third under head coach Laura Beeman. The Bows wrapped up the regular season starting at CSUN. Milani Bigby had a stellar performance, leading UH with 18 points. Lily Wahine Kapu followed right behind McBee, finishing with 16 points to capture the victory 65-62. UH closed their regular season over at Bakersfield on Saturday. The 85-48 victory over the Roadrunners secured the 200th win at UH for Coach Beeman. Wahine Kapu led the Bulls with 22 points. However, she got help from her teammates as Hoy hit 17 three-pointers, coming up one short of the program's single-game record. UH will take advantage of their double bye in the Big West Championship and prepare for the semifinals on March 15th at the Dollar Loan Center in Henderson, Nevada.
The last stretch of men's basketball season was made unforgettable by 2 wins at home. Last Wednesday, the Rainbow Warriors defeated CSUN 72-70 in another nail-biting game. Senior Bernardo da Silva stole the show in the game, leading the Rainbow Warriors with his 7th double-double of the year. He scored 18 points and snatched 12 rebounds. A few days later, on Saturday night, the Rainbow Warriors concluded the regular season with a 74-57 victory over Cal State Bakersfield in honor of Senior Night and securing the number 3 seed in the Big West Tournament. One of UH's 6 Senior Night honorees, Justin McCoy, shot 6-9 from the floor and 10-10 from the free throw line to score a game-high 23 points. UH will play on Thursday at the Dollar Loan Center in Henderson, Nevada.
Hawaii Baseball continued play this week in their series against Rice. Rice took the first game of the series on Friday, winning 5-2. However, UH was able to bounce back on Saturday in a big way. So Miao came up clutch in the 8th inning, going yard and securing the victory for the Bows 4-3. Sunday's game was a sheer domination by UH as they picked up the win 12-1. Rainbow Warrior Baseball has one more game in this series today before traveling to California to face CSU Bakersfield for their next series.
Rainbow Wahine wrapped up their non-conference schedule in the Outrigger Rainbow Wahine Classic.
The tournament was set to start on Wednesday, however, all games were canceled due to a rainout. The Bows kicked off the tournament on Thursday with a doubleheader against UConn and New Mexico. Wahine softball fell short to the Huskies 4-3, but bounced back with a win over the Lobos 3-1. Maya Nakamura demolished a pair of 3-run home runs to end of the first day of the tournament. Hawaii was set for another doubleheader on Friday, falling to the Huskies and Lobos, but bounced back on Saturday with a phenomenal win over Cleveland State 13-0. Sunday was the last day of the tournament, where the UH came out on top, defeating the Vikings 6-1.
Rainbow Wahine softball will kick off their first Big West Conference, scheduling at UC Santa Barbara on March 15th, followed by a doubleheader on March 16th.
Men's tennis played a split doubleheader on Saturday to wrap up the Golden State Invitational. UH put up a strong fight to defeat St. Mary's 4-3. However, in the tournament's final match at the Mara Welsh Tennis Center in Davis, California, the Bows fell short against Nevada 4-2. Hawaii will continue their travel on Tuesday to play the University of San Francisco in San Francisco.
High jumping junior Lillian Turbin made her debut in the NCAA Indoor Championships on Saturday at the track at New Balance Boston, Massachusetts. She finished 10th place, earning her a spot on the second team All-America, claiming the second All-America honor of her career. Turbin's injury kept her out of the first half of the season, but still qualified for the NCAA Indoor Championships. She's now one of the 3 different Rainbow Wahine athletes to compete at the Indoor National Championships.
Rainbow Wahine Water Polo split off the road with 2 games in California. In Davis, California, the Rainbow Wahine defeated number 16 UC Davis 12-7 on Friday to start Big West play. Senior Lot Sterdefeld scored a career high of 4 goals, plus another 2 goals from Lucia Gomez de la Punte, and Jordan Wedderburn scoring 3 goals, which makes for her second hat trick of the year. Just 2 days later, the Rainbow Wahine ended their road trip across Northern California with an almost fourth quarter comeback, but fell short 9-8, set back to number 4 California. This Saturday, the Rainbow Wahine head back to the Duke Ahanamoku Aquatic Complex to start their 4-game homestand starting against USC.
Hawaii defended home court with a 6-0 record to capture the Heineken Queens Cup. The Beach Bulls opened the 3-day tournament with a pair of wins against Nebraska and Boise State on Thursday. The Bulls kept their momentum going and then some, sweeping St. Mary's and Pepperdine on Friday. The Beach was set to face Pepperdine for the semifinal number 2 on Saturday, sending the waves away with another sweep. The Rainbow Wahine faced and came out triumphant over Boise State in the gold medal match 3-2. Congratulations to duo Jamie Santer and Alana Embry for winning the Heineken Queens Cup Most Outstanding Pair and the rest of the Wahine for stellar performances. The Bulls are set to hit the road for the East Meets West Invitational in Manhattan Beach, California starting on March 15th. Rainbow Wahine Volleyball Spring Matches start this Tuesday versus UNLV.
So come out and support.
I'm Ashanti.
I'm JT. Forgot your name or what?
Rainbow Roundup. I forgot.